What's up, buddies? Welcome to another episode of the Pack Gods. Thank you so much for the support on the series, and thank you for the comments on last episode. I would have to say, without spoiling too much, I'd highly recommend you go watch it, because I spent a lot of time editing that video and making it hopefully fun for you guys to watch me fail at life, because that was one of the most unsuccessful squad builds, team performances, episode in general I've ever had in the Pack God series. So if you want to see Nick raging and crying and losing his mind, go watch the last episode. It was a doozy. And I read through a lot of your guys' comments and stuff like that, and I understand. I know a lot of you guys are getting sick of the no chem glitch thing and you think it's ruined the series. I don't agree. I've said this now, I think, in a lot of videos now, but I think it's made the series better because now we can use whatever type of players we want. And I'm gonna try and make a promise to you guys that I'm not gonna build no chemistry teams forever. I'm really not. Because I kind of have a bit of an OCD as well, and I hate having red links everywhere and dumb stuff everywhere. But as you guys are undoubtedly going to see, have already seen, in the latest Poor Man Road to Glory episode, we destroyed the competition in Division 1 with a fully purchased, full Team of the Season team, but on no chem. Like, we had, well, not full Team of the Season, like, I don't want to spoil that video either if you haven't watched it yet, but Florenzi's second or third in form, his right back card, on one chemistry as a right center mid, maybe is the best right center mid I've used in FIFA this year. So go check out that video if you want to see a no chemistry team smash everyone in Division 1. So having said that, today's episode, I'm not going to promise you it's going to be a completely no chemistry team. I just want to build the best possible team. After last episode, we didn't get to open any pack. Now I'm really spoiling the episode for you guys in terms of what happened in it. But we didn't get to open any packs. We didn't do anything. I think we unlocked one card from the Pot of Potential. It was a disaster. So what I want to do today is just build an awesome team and just destroy the competition. We're going back to divisions. We're not going to play any feature tournaments because, you know what, for this series as well, one of the main targets is, of course, to win Division 1. So to start off the episode, let's get ourselves a card from the Pot of Potential and see what it's going to be. I would love if this was a pack challenge or something like that. And it's not. Team of the Season, Noboa. And Team of the Season, Mamayev. And as mentioned, just because I got Mamayev out of the Pot of Potential, I'm not going to build a squad around him, and I'm not going to use 4-2-3-1. I realize that as much as I loved using the formation, I just don't think it works for me. This is the dominant formation, so today's squad builder is going to be around this formation again. Now, I don't know why it's taken me so long to use Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. Like, he's an upgraded card, so technically on... He, I guess, benefits, if you will, from the quote-unquote chemistry glitch, where he doesn't need to be linked to anyone, and he'll still have all of his base stats. 96 pace, 83 shooting, 80 dribbling, and stuff like that. So, as a beast striker, I think we're just going to use him. We haven't used him yet in this series, so definitely going to build a team around him. And another quick note before I show you guys the completed team. Team of the Season, Noboa, is actually someone we don't have in the club, because remember, we set a challenge of... whoever we pull from the Pot of Potential first, I'm Out of the Match Noboa, or Team of the Season Noboa, we keep. We got I'm Out of the Match Noboa a few episodes ago, so the Team of the Season Noboa has been sold on. All right, and here is the team complete. Now, again, you're going to look at this and be like, what in the hell is this? But bear with me. This team, I'm putting my money on. I think this team is going to play very, very well. I just have to trust in it now. It has 60 chemistry, so obviously it's not the highest chemistry. Not the lowest chemistry either. 85 rated. I mean, the upgraded Aubameyang, he gets the advantage. He's going to be an incredible striker. Neymar's an upgraded card as well, so why not use him? I think as a left forward in the club, I don't have anyone really better. Team of the Season, Buffal, maybe. The third in form Mkhitaryan that we have, I think would be a great left forward as well. But we'll go with Neymar here. I've got a lot of choices for right forwards, but I think the best one, absolutely, at least on paper, is going to be Griezmann, and he's done well for us. Like, 13 games, 10 goals, 6 assists. He's done well, so he deserves to be in there. Marquisio, I think the midfield is one area in terms of at least box-to-box mids or attacking mids. We have endless choices. I could have gone with so many people here. I could have even put Serna up at right center mid, but I decided with Marquisio, the best defensive-minded midfielder in the game is 100%, in my opinion, Team of the Season, Gonalon. He's fantastic. I feel bad. I've said this a lot, but I do feel bad for people that haven't unlocked him because they are missing out big time. Why not? Again, left center mids, I've got some incredible choices. I do think that Matuidi is probably the best left center mid I have in my club, but why not use Marcelo? I love Marcelo, so I think he'll do great there. Left back is Brem, so why not? This defensive partnership, I think, is going to be the best that we have. I was actually debating going with Koulibaly here. The only reason I didn't go with Team of the Season Koulibaly is because this is the one thing, and this is this is the one thing, and it's probably superstition, but that I believe the chemistry glitch doesn't actually help or hurt or whatever, is goalkeepers. I think goalkeepers need to be on full chem. I've used some goalkeepers off of chem, and they've been just absolutely abysmal. I don't know if that's just in general goalkeepers are terrible, but this is the one thing that I wanted to do. So I don't have Hugo Lloris, and I don't have, nor is there a very good, how would you put that, French or Napoli goalkeeper, and I don't have them anyways, right? I think it's Pepe Reina or something like that. So either way, the best possible goalkeeper to get on full chem to fit these two center backs in is, of course, the upgraded Handanovic, and then we've used Serna at right back. Wish me luck, boys. We're going into Division 2. There is so much riding on this, boys. So much riding on this. Okay, so that's a nicely put together team. Technically, his De Bruyne isn't a day one card because his Wolfsburg card is a day one card. So he's got a few places in his team that are going to be hurting for chemistry. I didn't realize that my Handanovic, technically, because he's upgraded, actually isn't on full chem. So we'll see how that all goes. Nice. Here we go. Good connection or bad connection? I don't care. Ah, the idea was there. Delivery was poor. If I can get a goal for Pierre-Emerick, we get an extra pull from the pot of potential as well, because this is his debut game. Nice, Miranda. Okay, going along, just making this interesting. Oh God, I love lag. Lag is so good. It's so good. That's a goal too. What the? What? Good. You know what? You and your potato internet connection deserve not to score that. Get out of here, bro. Come on, Pierre-Emerick. Come on, Pierre. Oh my God, how was that so bad? Here it is. Ooh. Come on. What's happening? What? Have I just scored? Ew. I hate playing in lag. It's the worst thing ever. Anyways, we got a 1-0 lead. Thank God, man. Unfortunately, it wasn't Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang or anyone else that's having a debut, so there's no direct pull from the pot of potential just yet. Oh, what a play! Come on, onside two. No! No, look at that! Are you kidding me, man? I miss a clear-cut opportunity to make it 2-0. He walks down the field. My center backs just part like the Red Sea, and it's 1-1. What happened here? What in the actual hell was Toby Alderweireld doing tracking the run all the way to left back? Oh my, why'd you take a touch? Why didn't you let the ball run through? Fuck! What a pass. Yes, boys! Oh my God, I'm so salty. Oh God, and I think I have to show you guys that part of the video as well. Damn it! Let's just pretend we're really enjoying ourselves. At the very least, I get one pull from the pot of potential because that is Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang's debut game and debut goal for the club, and he puts us in the lead. Thank God. Ironically as well, the lag seems to have, well, no, it's there, it's now back, but anyways, it seems to have dwindled away. I see you, Marquisio! Boom! There it is, boys! Coming out of all the BS, dealing with awful lag, terrible gameplay, and we're still doing well. That's what I'm talking about. And we may have just caused a rage quit as well. So we have a pull from the pot of potential already. We should have a pull for a second half rage quit. And the victory means we get 4 pulls from the pot of potential to start off the episode, or I guess to keep the episode going at the very least. That is amazing. Thank God, man. I was convinced we were gonna lose that game. especially through the first half, the way that was playing, the bounces. Oh my god, it's unbelievable how, like, I can flip-flop back and forth from hating the game to loving the game, depending on what type of lag and BS goes on, but there's confirmation more for you guys. Game numero dos on the day. Oh my god. I am very scared about that. That's crazy. Why don't you chip that like a normal human being? Send him off. Like, please, for the love of Christ, thank you. Thank you. This is the 700th slide tackle of the game. But, I mean, what else is new, right? Me moaning at FIFA is not like that's, wow. Oh, that was nice as well. Almost. That has to be in. Thank you. Thank you, baby Jesus. Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang again. Thank you so much. Right off the half. And believe it or not, it's me getting a lucky bounce that results in the goal right here. Look at this. Look at this clearance. One touch through ball. Great finish, Pierre-Emerick. Thank God. Let's go. Take it. I'll take it. I'll take 2-0, boys. Dude, this guy is freaking really good. I hate him. I hate him. How is this guy so good with silvers? How are you so good with silvers, bro? Like, are you bored with gold, so you're just using silvers to cause people to rage like me? Like, I don't actually know. What would be the purpose? Please, please, please! Yes, boys! Keeper off his line. There you go. He's already ruined my life with having the keeper off his line for the first time. Are we causing a rage quit as well? Oh my god. Okay. Hold on a second. I don't think we get any bonuses for goals or anything. We'll have to check that out. But a second half rage quit is one pull. A clean sheet is another pull. And a victory is 4 pulls. So as of right now, we actually have 8 pulls from the pot of potential to end off the episode. We just need to see if someone has, like, a hat trick of goals and assists, right? So we've had 3 goals. So let's see if someone has a hat trick of goals and assists. Right now, it's on 8. Come on, EA. Let's see here. So Griezmann's got 2 goals. So if he even has 1 assist to Aubameyang, we're good. Come on, pack gods. Come on. Couple of good players and a lot of packs. That's what we're asking for. So out of 8 pulls, first one is, oh baby, it looks like packs. What is it going to be? Packs until we get a Frenchman. All right, we had that one semi-recently. Number 2, it's going to be, oh, ew. Team of the season, Oblak and Sanchez. Oblak is the worst goalkeeper in FIFA, as I discovered, unfortunately, in Fatal. Absolutely terrible card. All right, pull number, oh yeah, Hatem Ben Arfa, finally. It took us forever to get him. He's such a good card, so we'll probably do or include him in our next squad builder. So 4th pull from the pot of potential. Come on, baby. I like that. Come on, let's get a few more packs, please. Okay, another pull, another player. What is this? Team of the season, Gonzalo Higuain. Okay, I'm really enjoying using Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, but team of the season, Higgy, is also an absolute god. So let's go. This is pull number, what, 5? Here we go. Oh, what's this? Open packs until we get a top 6 Premier League player. Okay, that's great. And no, 3 more pulls. Perfect. Let's go. Pull number 6, sorry if I told you. Yeah, team of the season, Carvajal. You know what, I do have to say, the 2 problems from the squad that we built this episode was left center mid. I actually didn't feel like Marcelo was the greatest left center mid, so I put Marcelo back at left back, and we need to find a new left center mid and a new right back. Team of the season, Insigne as well. Oh my god, okay, so where are we at here? We have 1 more pull, come on. Come on, baby. Let's get packs, please, EA, please. Please. Now we got a lot of good players. This looks like packs. Packs until we get FIFA Manny, which is, of course, an English player. Okay, so great. We got a good amount of packs and quite a few players. So here are the main players. Obviously, all the players have been pulled out of the pot of potential. These guys are now all back in the club. So let me know who you guys think I should either include in this best possible divisions team for the club. I'm thinking right off the bat, we put Carvajal in at right back. I don't know if Ben Arfa would make a great left center mid. I think he's more attacking minded. Like, honestly, I'm actually considering maybe using Ben Arfa at right forward instead of Griezmann, and maybe replacing Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, with Higuain. Maybe, or maybe doing something like this, like Ben Arfa at right forward, and maybe even Griezmann up front or something along those lines. That could be a pretty deadly combo. But we'll see. We'll maybe change the team around next episode. More importantly, we need to now get some packs open. So, top six Premier League player, we need to open packs so we get one of them. That's Leicester, of course, Arsenal, Spurs, Bottle FC, no offense. Maybe a little bit of offense. Man City, Man United, and Southampton. So those are the six teams that we want to try to get in packs. A Frenchman, and then an Englishman. Well, that's really nice. I didn't realize that we'd have 45k packs to open right now. All right, let's get into it. So Premier League, France, England. Come on. I'll take a Team of the Tournament player or something like that. That would be... Oh, God. Okay, so let me just get myself sorted out here. So here's a top six Premier League player. Is there an Englishman in there as well? Unless I'm blind, it doesn't look like it. And is there a Frenchman? Ooh, no Frenchman either. Please. Something better than... Okay, I don't think I have Alonso yet. Never mind. Just kidding. I do have Alonso, and that's a little bit heartbreaking. So we did get an Englishman. So we got FIFA Manny. Please, no Frenchman. Nice! I don't even know what type of Frenchman I want. Maybe like a Marcel Desailly? Or... Wow. Ew. That's... horrifying. Oh man, come on. The packs have been a joke. Oh well. You know what? You win some, you lose some. Some episodes we have incredible pack luck, but awful gameplay like last episode. This episode, really, really good gameplay. Very successful in terms of pulling cards out of the pot of potential. Pack luck, not all that great. But I do hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, remember to smash the like button. And as always, we'll catch you on the flip side. Peace!